bullet engine? The whistle? Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Australia, Series 1. The Bully Engine's Whistle. Mike was thinking of his time when he made a mistake of making his whistle pop off when he met a cow in the way. I hope I don't do it again on Tasman Sobel. He said to Rex, like I said, we engines can't be when no whistles are on us. Well, you best not, said Rex. Mike went to take his truck of stone to the tipyard market, began wheezing steam. Hello, said the driver. You seem ready for the job. I was wanting to take two trucks, driver. Some engine I didn't know was thinking I'm a toy, but I'm not. I'd like to show him if he tries looking over a little engine. You mean like Tim, the new engine that arrived from the other railway? Yes, something like that. How did you know the engine when I first met him? He was all right, but when I saw you in the book, I thought I'll go small gauge and got him angry sick in the head. That reminds me, he was asking you back. He never learns sense and changes. He's working in the tipyard, so you better watch out. Mike arrived at the tipyard. He looked about to see if Tim was at work. There he is, driver. He seems rather bored. Poor engine, he's been here all day. And look what he's lost. His whistle. Gosh, he's all quiet. Mike delivered the stone to a pile. Oi, you there, said Tim. Mike looked at the engine. You're the engine that overlooked us, little engines. We still work all right, but my driver told me you were wanting him back. Of course I want him back, and I do wish my whistle was given to me. You mean something like this I found a while ago? Why, that's my whistle. Where did you find it? I can't tell you. You don't deserve it. When he got home, he told Mike about Tim. What? That bully who said the same thing to me? Said Rex. Oh, I can't stand him on Tasman's show door. He's been wanting to have his driver back for years, but he doesn't know he's retired to narrow gauge. It's odd, so what do you think we should do? The fat controller might sort him out. He hasn't seen him for years. Good idea. The fat controller came up. So you know about the new engine that was never learning the changes? Yes, sir, said Rex. We were wanting him off this island, so we can live on in peace. I wouldn't like to see him again. I got his whistle. He deserves not to have it after waking anyone at night when he doesn't sleep. My driver knows him from my retired one. He only wants him forgotten by sending him to the tip yard to work as a slave. I had a call from the tip yard saying he's needing to move on, so we'll have to send him to some place he can be put. But other railways don't want him. He haunted England, America, and Australia. The scrapyard is where he'll go to. Shall I put his whistle in there? That's a good idea. Let's get him off the tip. But when they got to the tip yard, they saw Tim had backed into the stones. The manager came up. Who's this junk, Mike? He said. That's Tim, sir, wanting his driver back, but he's retired. I got his whistle. No wonder he's grumbling for his loss of them. His crew told me they're fed up with the engine and deserves to not run. I can't say he's any good. He just wants to haunt the tip. The fat controller had a tough word with Tim. Considering your bulliishness to every railway in the world, it may be better without you, and I should speak to your owner who brought you in the first place. Tim didn't say anything. He knew his life was about to end. So life went on very well, and Mike's retired driver still drives narrow gauge engines, but would rest. The world didn't know it was Tom in disguise. He'd been undercover for years, but has to hide his name. We know about the affairs he was in, don't we?